Electricity is the power in modern life. At every moment of life, we need electricity. Round the clock, electricity. Our life would be miserable without electricity. We require electricity for many gadgets during the entire day. Our evenings and nights would be dark without electricity. Even late into the night, we fall asleep with humming fans or air conditioners. Many of us are aware that the unrestricted consumption of electricity causes a lot of pollution, environmental disasters, and is one of the main reasons why our earth starts losing its eco-balance. But we do not admit to ourselves the severity of the problem. India is the sixth largest energy consumer in the world, accounting for 3.4% of global energy consumption. As a result of the economic growth of the country, the demand for energy has been growing at an average rate of 3.6% per annum over the past 30 years. About 75% of the electricity consumed in India has been generated by thermal power stations. Thermal power in India is predominantly generated by coal. The heat from coal combustion generates steam for driving turbines which produce electricity. Coal is in fact a combination of so many things, organic and inorganic. Coal contains several minerals. All these contents of coal are turned into ash after burning of the coal. This ash is called fly ash. For every unit of electricity generated from coal-based thermal power plants in India, about 300 grams of fly ash is produced. A total of 149 million tons of fly ash is generated every year by all thermal power plants across the country. When the coal is burnt at a thermal power plant, it produces fly ash as well as furnace bottom ash. Fly ash represents approximately 80% of the total ash generated. Fly ash is fine dust particles emitted by the combustion process. The fly ash also contains a number of pollutants. If allowed to reach the environment, this dust becomes a reason for health concerns. To avoid this, in many cases, the fly ash is trapped in filters mixed with water, and the resulting slurry containing 90% water and 10% ash is dumped into ash ponds or ash lagoons. If fly ash seeps through, it may severely contaminate the groundwater, lower fertility of soil, harm plants, and disturb food chains. With around 70 thermal power plants in India, fly ash ponds have claimed nearly 30,000 hectares, turning them unfit for another use as arable land. Besides this, existing ash ponds are getting filled up fast and additional dumping space is scarce. That is the reason why the further production of fly ash becomes a real worry. As explained before, thermal power stations in India originate tremendous pollution by emitting fly ash and other hazardous elements, as well as by attracting expenditure of millions of rupees for dumping the fly ash. Of course, development needs this. On one hand, we need more electricity, so more thermal power stations, and we cannot reject the fly ash pollution out of them. So, the name of the problem is fly ash. For India, fly ash has been in the past only a source of pollution. For other countries in the world, it has a value. The fly ash is recycled to improve the quality of concrete. And this is nothing new. We can trace this use back to 2200 years ago. Just take a look at several ancient monuments, in the construction of which volcano ash, natural fly ash had been used. The Roman Colosseum was built in 200 AD. It stands proudly till today. Time and wars were not able to damage it. The strength of the structure, believe it or not, was caused by the mortar which contains ash from volcanoes. An example from our days, Burj Khalifa at Dubai, presently the highest building in the world. For its construction, fly ash has been used in concreting. Experts and scientists unanimously declare that popularizing use of fly ash is essential if we want to convert the trouble of pollution into means of prosperity. Various scientists initiated research to find a perfect solution to this problem. The experts discussed the issue in seminars, focusing on the physical and chemical properties of fly ash that makes it suitable for use in concrete, for building dams, marine structures, bridges, flyovers, and skyscrapers. After detailed research, they found out that, on one hand, the use of fly ash in concrete reduces the requirement for cement and, on the other hand, increases the strength and durability of the structure. Processed fly ash is a perfect partial cement replacement. Due to its contents of silica and alumina, it adds strength to the concrete. It also prolongs the life of the construction.
When I visited India in 1999 to look at the environmental problems the subcontinent is facing, I realized that most of the 100 million ton of coal fly ash produced every year by Indian coal-fired power stations at that time was simply disposed into all types of lagoons and landfills. Knowing that pulverized fuel ash is a valuable ingredient in high-quality concrete, I could not resist to make a proposal to the government of the Indian state of Maharashtra to set an example for value-added application of this power station waste stream in concrete. After tough negotiations, I agreed a contract with the Maharashtra State Electricity Board to recycle all newly generated fly ash of their Nashik thermal power station on an exclusive base. It was the foresight of the board of MSEB, the Maharashtra State Electricity Board, which allowed this to happen and to create a base on which further investment into new recycling plants became possible.
DER Group started to execute the contract with Maharashtra State Electricity Board to process the fly ash of the Nashik Thermal Power Station. Let us make a tour through this fly ash processing plant. The fly ash is unloaded into the raw ash silo in the plant. This is how the journey of raw, unprocessed fly ash goes on. The plant classifies the highly specialized pozzolanic material with ultra-high strength and elevated specifications. The classifier has variable speed rotor with multiple closely spaced rejector blades and high-speed operation for ultra-fine fly ash. The feed is conveyed into the air classifier by gravity. The fines are pneumatically conveyed through the cage and collected in a product dust collector. Generally, the superfine is suited for highly specialized ultra-fine products. Big percentage of fly ash is exported. For this purpose, fly ash is packed into 1-ton jumbo bags, palletized, shrink-wrapped, and loaded into containers. The recycled and processed fly ash in India is about 50% cheaper than cement. As it is mixed in concrete along with cement, it considerably reduces the cost of the resulting concrete. According to the factual reports, using fly ash saves about 20% of the concrete cost. Obviously, savings of 20% in one of the main construction materials means more infrastructure for India at the same budget. Hence, there is a tremendous demand for this product in India and in many countries of Middle East, Asia, and Africa. The cement producing companies create a lot of pollution. For every ton of cement produced, nearly 1 ton of carbon dioxide is emitted into the air. By using fly ash in concrete, the user saves cement and consequently helps to reduce cement production. This automatically helps to reduce pollution caused by cement industries. Besides the technical and commercial issues, there is another phase to the plant. This village has been suffering from the pollution for about 40 years. The farmers were hesitant to grow certain crops on the soil with the presence of fly ash. The fly ash had made their life difficult. The danger of contamination of drinking water was always hanging over the village. Fly ash processing plant has taken the interests of the village of Eklare to its heart. There is hardly any newly generated fly ash in these lagoons. Fly ash is processed in an environment-friendly way and is not flying around or getting into the soil. This has improved the quality of life of the villagers. The plant has resolved most of the unpleasant aspects connected with fly ash. People here are happy to have such a caring corporate neighborhood.
म्हणजे तोट्यात नाही काही फायदेशीरच आहे ना कंपनी तुम्ही काढली एवढा खर्च केला त्याच्या तो गरीब दुबळ्या लोकांना रोजगार मिळाला किंवा आमची पिकापाण्याची जी नुकसान जी होत होती
बरोबर
ती आता होत नाही
थोडा
फायदा आहेच ना शेवटी आमचा
व्हॉट इज ही सेइंग दॅट
ऑलरेडी इन 2006 द डर्क नासिक फ्लाय ॲश प्रोजेक्ट वॉज कन्सिडर्ड बाय इंडियाज नोबेल प्राईज लॉरिएट डॉक्टर पचौरी as one of the 25 best Indian examples for corporate environmental responsibility. The Indian government has set an ambitious target to add approximately 78,000 megawatt of installed generation capacity by 2012. The total demand for electricity in India is expected to cross 9,50,000 megawatt by 2030. To meet this requirement, the government has planned to install several new thermal power plants in India. Let us hope that the government will also take care of the environment. It will make efforts to protect people, animals, and agriculture from pollution. Projects like the Dirk plant should be considered as an excellent example. The fly ash recycling and processing plant is not only business but also a great social service. The earth gives us natural resources and that we have an obligation to reciprocate to the earth. It is our duty to take care of the environment for the generations to come.